Hi everyone, I'm Muse, and today I'm giving a tutorial on how to use the text tool in Clip Studio Paint. This tutorial applies to both the Pro and EX versions of the software, so do not worry about any differences. First is where to find the tool. On the default workspace in Clip Studio Paint, you can find the text tool on the left side towards the bottom. It looks like the letter A. You can also push the T button on your keyboard as a shortcut to the tool. Second are the tool options. Once you have selected the text tool, a window directly below it titled Tool Property will show all the options that you have for your text. The first selection is the font, which opens a drop-down menu of all fonts available on your computer. To use a new font in Clip Studio Paint, it needs to be downloaded to your computer first. On the font drop-down menus, you can choose to preview the fonts by name, see the names displayed in the font, or see a preview of the fonts in uppercase, lowercase, and numbers. By clicking on the gear icon, you can make custom lists for your fonts that can then be selected from the other, smaller drop-down menu. Directly below the font selection drop-down are choices for font size, font style, which gives you an option between bold, italic, underline, and strikeout, justify, which is where you can set whether the font is aligned to the right, center, or left, and text direction, with options for horizontal or vertical. Finally, there's the option for the text color, which by default can be set to use the primary color you have selected, the secondary color you have selected, or the user color, which by default is black. Third is how the tool works. Once you've decided where you want to place the text on your canvas, click once and a text box will appear. Whatever you type will appear in this box. You can highlight your text or press the Command and A keys at the same time to select everything and make changes as you go. You can freely move around the text box, and grabbing one of the corners or sides of the box with your cursor can increase and decrease the size. The opacity and blending modes can also be freely changed at any point. Fourth are extra options you can use with the text tool. If you want your text to have a border, go to the Layer Property section in your workspace. By default, it can be found to the right underneath your navigation window. It can also be brought up by going to Window in the top menu and clicking Layer Property. Underneath Effect, you will see a black dot with a white border. This is the Border Effect button. Clicking on it will give you a white outline by default. You can adjust the thickness of the outline by clicking on the arrows next to Thickness of Edges, and change the color by selecting your desired color on the color wheel, and then clicking inside the Edge Color box. Clicking the arrow next to the Edge Color box will open a color picker that has the same effect. If this is how you want your text to look, then you're set. But if you want to make further edits outside of these options, you will want step number 5, raster and free transform. Let's say you want your text to have different shapes throughout, or not look like it's all on the same line. In this case, you will first want to rasterize your text, and then shape it using the transform and lasso tools. Rasterizing means that the text will act like a normal layer, a raster layer. It won't have the text box around it anymore, so make sure that you have the font, color, and size you like before rasterizing, as there's no changing it afterwards without hitting the undo button. To rasterize your text, right-click its layer and select Rasterize from the menu that pops up. Now the text is treated like a regular raster layer. You can now use other editing tools on your text as you like, such as the lasso tool or the eraser tools. For more extreme edits to size and shape, use the free transform and mesh transformation options that can be found in the Edit tab under Transform, and do whatever you'd like. You may have noticed throughout the video that there are other sub-tools underneath the text tool that are especially interesting for comic artists. My next tutorial video will be about the word balloon tool, so please subscribe and turn on notifications to be notified when it's uploaded. If you have further questions, leave a comment or check out Clip Studio's official help site, linked in the description below. If this video was helpful for you, please consider giving it a like and sharing it with people who want to learn more about how to use Clip Studio Paint. Thanks for watching!